So when it comes to inspecting undercarriage, there's a few things we want to measure or check. And we're hopefully going to be able to demonstrate them here for you today. The first thing we're going to demonstrate is how to check our grouser height or our grouser wear. Those grousers are what provide the traction. Over time, they will wear down. So to measure them, what you'll need is a straight edge and a ruler. We're using CAT part number 5P3277 ruler, which measures in both standard and decimal measurements. So we would take our straight edge, put it across two tracks, try to hold it this way, and then we will measure down to the base of the track shoe or track pad. And there we can see our measurements. So we're at 1.6, and I have four lines after that. And on that tape, this tape measure here, that would be 1.68 inches would be our grouser height. You can measure it in a few locations and then take an average reading. Our next thing that we want to measure is our track link height. As this track wears, these links will wear on the surface of the rollers and the idler. And you want to check the height to make sure it's not worn down too far. Once again, we will use our straight edge and put that across our link. And we will measure with the tape measure up to the base of the track shoe, which is equal to the top of the link, and measure down to our straight edge. The straight edge makes it much easier than trying to find a rounded edge. It gives us a crisp line to go to. And here we are measuring 3.5, and I see two lines after the 5, so 3.54 on this tape measure. If you were measuring in metric, this one here, looks like it would measure 91 millimeters. You can also measure the track bushing external wear. Remember, that track bushing, as it goes around, this is what contacts the sprocket in the back. Over time, there will be wear that occurs. Here you can see on this bushing I have removed from another track that you can clearly see a worn area from it contacting the sprocket. This is also one way, if you can tell if tracks have already been turned. If the bushings have been turned and you reach in there and feel, you will feel this worn spot or flat edge up at the top, which I do not feel on this. So these track links or bushings have never been turned on this track. To measure that, you're going to want to use a tool like this, a caliper, and you can go in there and adjust it to the thickness of the bushing. By itself, the caliper will not give you a measurement, but once you have it set to the same dimension, you would simply hold that up to the tape measure, and there you can obtain your reading to get your bushing wear, the external bushing wear. In a different video, we'll show you how to check for internal pin and bushing wear by measuring track pitch. You can also use a caliper, probably a larger size than this, to check the wear on the rollers. Up top here, we have our carrier roller. You would want to check the width of it. On our track rollers down below, you would same thing. Want to check the surface where the track links are riding, where they're rubbing. The idler flange, identify the specifications for that. A lot of times what they'll have you do is measure across the raised surface and measure down to determine how much wear has occurred on your idler flange. You want to do a visual inspection of some other things. You want to check for any outside pin wear on these links. Ideally, they should look like this, which are relatively unworn. They shouldn't be contacting any of the guards. That can be a sign of looseness or something being misaligned. You can check for idler flange side wear. You shouldn't see too much wear on the side of here. Could be a sign of misalignment. Maybe it's working sideways on slopes, which is not really a good practice. That can also cause that side wear. And same with roller flange side wear. The drive sprocket, some machines, particularly older machines, would provide a profile gauge. Anymore, that's not normally provided. When you change track lengths or put new bushings in there, you would need to change the sprocket with it to match that new bushing surface. So in most cases, the sprocket is going to be changed when you turn pins and bushings or replace the track chain. But what you want to look at is make sure it's not excessively sharp. As these wear, they become sharper, pointier, and they would begin to look like a bicycle sprocket. As you get more experienced and see more sprockets, you'll be able to recognize a severely worn one from a relatively new one. Underneath this guard here, we don't have it removed, but there is a large recoil spring. You'll want to check that to make sure that recoil spring is not cracked or damaged in any way. You would remove the guard, make sure you reinstall it. Check the track frame. That's the part that's going to be holding all the components and thereby supporting the weight of the machine. You want to look for any cracks or broken welds. Obviously, any missing fasteners, whether they're in track rollers, or an idler, that would be a problem. And on the track shoes, make sure all the bolts are there. That's going to require moving the machine forward because right now we can only see half the track. We cannot see what is down against the ground. Lastly, you're going to want to check the guards. This has a guard in the front and a guard midway back here. Same thing, make sure all the fastening parts are there, make sure they're not mangled, rubbing anything. They can take a lot of abuse. Sometimes they need to be straightened, rewelded. Sometimes they may need to be replaced. So that's how we do a visual inspection of our tracks and some of the measurements to help determine the amount of life and what service needs to be done on that undercarriage.